This is one of the most mysterious sounds in the universe. A billion years ago, two black holes collided at nearly the speed of light. The violent explosion distorted the fabric of space-time with ripples called gravitational waves.
A gravitational wave is literally the stretching and compressing of space-time, as predicted by Einstein over 100 years ago. Because mass actually bends space-time, and so if mass jiggles, space-time jiggles as well. So Einstein predicted that there should be a way that gravitational waves exist, but he actually thought that there was no chance that anyone would ever detect them because they were so minuscule.
Then in 2015, scientists at a gravitational wave observatory known as LIGO had a breakthrough.
We have detected gravitational waves. We did it.
We were super happy to be in the era of gravitational waves.
Gravitational waves travel at the speed of light, and they carry information about the most extremely relativistic objects in the universe, including objects like black holes. So at higher frequencies, the ground-based detectors like LIGO are doing a great job of measuring black holes at the solar mass or maybe 100 solar mass scale. But if you really want to measure the most massive black holes in the universe, or even just different kinds of gravitational waves, you have to go to much, much lower wavelengths.
For 15 years, an international coalition known as NanoGrav has been trying to detect gravitational waves at low frequencies using a technique called a pulsar timing array.
We use some of the largest radio telescopes in the world to measure a whole bunch of pulsars and hopefully to directly detect gravitational waves in the universe.